This could be it, Gordon. Careful. Here they come. I don't get it. Why are they hanging around here? The control system is going crazy. Looks like they're compressing a huge packet of data. But why? Find a way through the control room. The elevator's down in the core entry. Let me see if I can call it back to this level. All right, let me get access for you. We could be out of contact while you're in, at least until you shut it down. It's weird. They're wide open. It's like they're just dumping everything. I'll catch what I can and... These readings are off the chart. I hope it's not too late to re-engage the containment field. Good thing you know what you're doing. No wonder you were one of Dr. Kleiner's prized pupils. Well, here's your elevator. Gordon, I wish there was something else I could do to help.
It doesn't look like I'm standing on anything. Holy balls, Bloom. Whoa. Ow. I don't remember them attacking you. Hey, I got him. He goes, fuck you. This was actually the spot I was talking about where I said that I'm perfectly fine with there being so much bloom and so much lighting in this area, because in all reality, you wouldn't even be able to look at that. I mean, it's not like my eyes see like a camera or anything, but I don't know, just looks good here. Hey, shield. Bow. That really doesn't get old. So if the radiation affects me, why doesn't it affect the Combine? Whoa, I almost just ran straight off the edge there. I mean, I guess you could just say because aliens, but whatever. Because as far as I know, Combine are not humans. As much as I like Half-Life 2, I still would like to know why they decided to change Half-Life 2 so much from Half-Life 1. Like, it honestly doesn't feel like a true sequel. I mean, it's amazing, don't get me wrong, because, ow, fuck out of here, Manhax. Yeah, Half-Life 2 is amazing, don't get me wrong, it's just I preferred Half-Life 1 a lot more than Half-Life 2. I got a shield! I am invincible! No! I'm invincible with the shield, I need it! No, there's just another one there. Ouch. So I have it on normal difficulty. Bullet damage is drastically higher in C-mod. C-mod? What am I saying C-mod for? The cinematic mod, which I guess you could call it C-mod. That looks really good. Stop shooting me, it hurts. They all dead? I need a suit charger. Here, Combine. Whoa. Yes. He did that. Yeah, I heard you guys. Man hacks. Another one of those places. To work. Yeah, if I can get it through. Whoa. Okay, that will work even better. There we go. That really shouldn't work. Ow. I hear more Combine. Thank you. Aw, my gravity gun. How much less white is in that room? Oh, and now it's suddenly really dark again.
Gordon! You did it! The containment system's back in place. It won't last forever, but at least we've bought a little time. While you were in there, I did some poking around on the control deck. They were trying to start a chain reaction, all right. But destroying the Citadel is just a side effect. Since we took out Brain's reactor, this is the only way they have to send a transmission packet back to wherever they came from. I can't tell what the packet contains, but it's important enough that they're willing to sacrifice the whole Citadel to send it off. We need to get it back to my dad and Dr. Kleiner at the outpost right away. I've been pulling down a copy. Whatever it is, I have a feeling it's bad news for all of us. There's something else. Take a look.
I'm fairly sure I've pinned down the location of the project. It's hard to say how much of it might have survived intact, or whether there's anything remaining that could compromise our work, if it were discovered by the Combine. We'll need to take a close look at it, of course, but I should be able to give a better opinion within a few hours. If the site is where we think it is, then it should be no more than... I'm gonna cut this short, we may have been spotted.
She's in serious trouble. We need to get this and the transmission packet to my dad. He'll know what to do with it. The packet's done copying. I've got it right here. Now let's get the hell out of here. Uh-oh. I think they felt that. I secured an exit elevator. It's this way. Come on! Run! Something tells me they know we're going to get a mail. This lift will take us to a train platform. If we can hitch a ride, it should take us straight out of the city. Hey, the gravity gun's back to normal. Well, it was nice while it lasted.
Kind of figured they'd be loading there. All of this red. They are mad. He just, like, crouched up the ramp. That guy just got fucked. I want that gun.
Coast is clear.
Why is that so amusing?
This is our train. Let's get in. Come on, let's get in.
Whoop.
What's in this copy we made, but they're not thrilled about us having it. You know, all things considered, we're not doing too... Oh no. It's a stalker car. God damn the Combine. This is what happens to you if you resist. Or if you're just in the wrong place at the wrong time. God, I hope you don't remember who you are. All right. Let's see where this train is headed. With any luck, we should be well out of the city before it's too late. Thank God we're not on foot. Let's hope the worst is over. It looks like you saved our lives again. What's that?
Yep, it doesn't look like the mod installed correctly. Because it's supposed to start loading right here, and I can't get it to start loading. Because the person that made this mod decided, you know what would be awesome? Let's have 36 different files you have to extract and then combine and then install, leaving it wide open for data corruption every fucking time you do it. What is wrong with a single ISO file that installs perfectly fine instead of this pile of shit? The guy that knows how to make this mod is just great at modding a game, but he's a fucking amateur at actually uploading it. And a complete moron. It's incredibly skeptical of criticism. And this is a giant problem with the mod. Just upload it to ModDB, let Dzura install it. Then it works fine, not this shit.